What's happening?
I don't know. Unless, tomorrow's newspaper. Do you still have it?
Yeah. Local accountant beaten. Left for dead.
Local accountant Arthur McFly was severely beaten and left for dead on the steps of the Hill Valley Courthouse last night.
They're gonna kill my grandpa?
Tannen's goons, no doubt. Probably in retaliation for Arthur answering that subpoena you delivered.
What are we gonna do?
I'm not sure what we can do. According to this, your grandfather was dumped on the doorsteps of the courthouse 5 minutes ago.
My dad's picture is disappearing.
That's a time stream catching up with your grandfather's fatal wounds. Which means your father will never be born, and neither will you. Unless... When did you last see your grandfather?
4 o'clock, in the town square.
Let's give him enough time to make his deposition.
Right.
We'll have to be careful not to run into ourselves.
That shouldn't be a problem in your case. I mean, you were in jail.
All right, let's get moving before the police find us.
Freeze! Step out of the car with your hands up.
Driver's side, passenger side.
What was that?
What was what?
Crap!
I heard something back there.
I think you're mistaken, officer.
Well, looks like I caught me a fugitive. Carl Sagan, the speakeasy arsonist.
Alleged speakeasy front drive. Arsonist, if you don't mind.
Oh, jeez. Really?
What the heck kind of buggy is that?
Stay back. It's a prototype, still untested, liable to blow up at any moment.
Or suddenly take off
without warning.
Is that so?
The key.
There it is again.
I think the AI is playing tricks on you, officer.
Have to go row and row.
Foreign job, a German or something?
Not at all. This is solid American workmanship.
Now I'm sure something's back there.
Oh, come on, this key is right there.
Looks like something out of Buck Rogers.
A year from now, everybody will be driving these babies.
I just have to get the car started.
I wouldn't be surprised if there's a promotion in this. You're getting to be a valuable commodity in Hill Valley.
Well, that's very...
Hey! Stop!
Dad!
No! Save your grandfather! I'll be fine until you get back.
You got it, Doc.
Go, idiot mouse! I think some sow is missing.
What was that?
Oh, here we go again.
455. Artie's gotta be in there somewhere, spilling his guts to the DA. There he is. All I gotta do is get to him before...
Mr. Callahan?
Uh-oh.
I was wondering if I could do a little follow-up interview with you about the plight of poor Mr. Sagan. My sources indicate that Judge Brown will be setting him free tomorrow.
I wouldn't bet on that.
What's that?
Nothing. Listen, can we talk later? I've really gotta get to the courthouse right now.
Really? Why?
With Grandpa.
My grandpa needs me as a character witness to get a fishing license.
Oh, well then, carry on. And do put that vicious dog of yours on a leash, will you? We have laws about that sort of thing, you know.
Sure, no problem. Ah! Oh, come on, yesterday, Marty. Stop talking. Get moving.
Oh, I die.
Einstein? Einstein, what is it, boy? Go away, boy!
No! Go away!
Crap! Einstein!
Uh-oh.
Is it a squirrel, Einie? You want to play? Okay, let's play.
Where should I throw?
Want the stick, boy? Want to chase it?
Oh, arrow key and click and drag and look around. That's new. Damn it. Gazebo.
Go on, boy. Einstein.
Oh, come on. That's a bit too short.
Bad dog. Oh, come on, Einie. What are you up to, Einie? Okay, let's try this again.
Anything else? Gazebos? Gazebo? It. Oh, right. Okay. They're gonna take a while.
You!
Uh-oh. Oh,
get this mangy animal away from me!
Come on, Einstein. Get away from the nice lady.
My shoes!
Einstein, no! Way to go, Einie. Now to get into that courthouse and grab Artie before Tannen's guys.
Uh-oh.
Hey. Oh, God. Hey.
According to my calculations, the rotary engine for a full-scale rocket drill requires 1.21 kilowatts of power. Can you check over my work to make sure? Are you all right?
Yeah. Yeah. But I need to get to Arthur.
Why?
I have to brief him on what to say to the DEA.
Oh, are you the legal expert now? Come on. Shouldn't we be getting on with our work? We're on a strict deadline, right?
Sure. You start without me. Turn around and start walking and I'll catch up to you in just a few minutes.
Huh?
Oh, hell. Oh, my God! What the hell is that?
What's what?
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to you.
No, I mean before, while I was walking towards you.
I wasn't talking to anyone. I was working on equations for my rocket drill.
No, I mean after. Never mind. Let's get going.
Follow me.
The other Marty, why you be so annoying?
I thought I'd never leave. At least now I have a clear shot to the courthouse.
I can drag to look around, why? What?
You gotta come with me. Look, you're in a lot of danger.
What do you mean I'm in danger?
No time to explain, Gran. Artie, just promise me you'll stay at the police station until-
Artie McFly. Just the guy we're looking for.
Hey, fellas.
Run!
Get him!
What? The soap guy? Where's he come from?
Artie? I better pick up their trail before I start fading out again.
Oh, not the soap again.
Looks clear.
All right, McFly. Let's go see the boss.
Buddy, how's my favorite accountant doing?
Oh, I've been better. Oh,
I'm so sorry to hear that, McFly. Trixie, take a powder, doll. We got business to discuss.
K.O., you boys play nice now. Mwah! Nice to see you again, Audie.
You too, Miss Trotter.
Yeah, yeah, we're all happy as clams. Now scram! Are you guys stupid? What are you thinking, bringing this fish food to my doorstep?
We just thought
that was your first mistake. Thinking. Look at me. Do you ever catch me thinking? Huh? Don't answer that. Look, just drag him inside, find out what he told the DA, then get rid of him.
I think we can handle that.
Good. Now, if you don't mind, I've got an arsonist to snuff out. And will one of you slobs start hauling these crates in?
We're on it, kid.
So far, so good. Huh.
I better get in there quick.
Medium, big crate. Up and away. Medium.
Contents. One winged goddess.
Oops.
Oops.
Right, can I go inside?
Nice fit. Here goes nothing.
Get the crinks, cue ball. Stir the soup, cue ball. Clean out the bloodstains, cue ball. Shit, I'm not a gangster, I'm a freaking butler. Now, which one of you guys goes in first? Jeez, for a gal with no arms, you sure is heavy! Whoops.
Ow! Do you mind? I'm trying to conduct a professional interrogation over here.
Where should I put this?
Just shove it behind the bar.
I'll just shove you behind the bar.
Come on, Audie. Jeez, how much chloroform did you put on that rag anyway?
What?
Because I'm having a hard time bringing Sleeping Beauty here around.
Let me see. Hey, Audie! We got a few questions about you and the DA.
DA, day, D.
You see what I'm working with here?
Seems to be catching.
Zane, wake up!
Oh, sorry, boss. This stupid cold got me wiped out.
Well, try to stay awake long enough to finish that poster, will ya? We got a club to open in a few days. And turn off that sign, would ya? Wake up, sleepyhead.
Only if I can call up from everyone here. Let's grab this first. Come in handy.
Ooh, no wonder Artie's so out of it.
I figure we put Kid's Wall of Fame gallery up over the bar.
That ought to give the place
a touch of class. Is the panic button?
Cause, you know, nothing says class like pictures of dead guys.
L Kid.
I switch. Okay, man. Thanks for stopping by, Chiru.
Picasso's in my way.
I'll catch you up later on. You please, mate.
I'll never get to that switch while Picasso's in my way.
This is gonna be the swellest speech.
I can't take that. Zane would know something's up.
What about using color foam in the ink bottles?
Oh, hey guys, I don't feel so.
And
hey, wake up, you lazy bum!
Must have been the cold.
Cold my eye. He's been dipping into the inventory.
The inventory. One more on down. Two to go.
Shouldn't kid be back by now? How long's it take to stroll next door and
what paper? Do I spy with my little eye? Word games?
It's a panic button, this thing.
Sleep tight, moron. He's a good artist, but he can't hold his chloroform.
Okay. What else are out here?
I hope the Sisters of Mercy approve of our redecorating.
Trixie Trotter, world-famous chanteuse. I never heard of her.
Okay, I think the sigh I can activate it now. There we go. Oops.
Ow.
That's
what
a hole.
I think we blew a fuse.
Well, go up to the soup kitchen and get a new one.
Why me?
You'd rather hang around and talk to this guy, huh?
Happy days are here again.
Yeah, I'll just get that fuse.
Oh, so this.
Wake up, sleepyhead.
Panic button with that. Yep, doesn't work.
Fuse is blown, all right.
Oh, in that case. Anything I could do? Call of. Oh, could I?
Oh God!
Oh, damn! What?
You're trying my patience, Artie. Wake up, sleepyhead.
McDermott's Canadian whiskey.
You take everything. Okay, what? I. Hello. Huh?
Premium bootleg hooch.
Come on, Artie, wake up.
There's gotta be something about doing this again. I know it's weird.
Bam! Right in the kisser.
That's safe.
Hey, you. Wait, do I know you?
Not for about 40 years.
Is anyone down there?
Everything's spinning.
Uh-oh.
Come on, Artie. Let's get out of here before these jerks get a chance to kill you.
Wait a minute. They were gonna kill me?
Great.
This isn't funny, guys.
Well, that.
Dog. Perfect timing. Hang on, Grandpa. We've got a pickup to make.
I thought you'd never ask. Ah, what's he doing here?
It's a long
story.
Let's
get in.
Oh, son of a...
And then I carried Artie to the DeLorean and came back to get you.
Fascinating.
So we can go home now, right?
Not yet. We still have this loose end to tie up.
No, don't tie me up again.
He's coming around.
Please be careful. You won't be safe in Hill Valley as long as Kit Tannen remains at large.
Don't worry, I'm going far away from Hill Valley, and I'm never coming back.
No!
No.
He's got to hook up with Grandma.
What's her name?
It's Sylvia.
You know a woman named Sylvia?
No.
Well, she knows you. We'll know you. It's vitally important that you two meet.
Oh, I get it. You want me to be part of some undercover sting operation.
No, possibly.
Yeah. Are you G-Man?
Uh-huh.
Something like that.
Sure, anything for Uncle Sam. I'll stay nearby and wait for this Sylvia. But in the meantime, I'll lay low.
Good man.
When can I expect to see you again?
That was a close call.
You think he'll be okay?
You're not fading out, are you? Besides, Arthur will be completely out of danger come August 25th.
August 25th?
That's the date Kit Tannen is finally put behind bars. How's that picture of your dad?
Still there.
Good. Let's get out of here before we accidentally elect Hoover to a second term.
Well, something's still gone wrong. Damn the time paradox and butterfly effects and chaos theories.
Well, everything looks okay.
Are you
chaos
sure?
Control.
See, McFly residence. So, want to come in? Maybe hang out a while? I want my dad to see for himself that you're still around.
How's it going, little man?
You've got to go. I understand, Doc. You've got a life to lead, kids to raise and all that.
No, I've got to go to the bank and stop that estate sale you told me about.
Oh.
You go find your pop. I'll be back within the hour.
See you soon, Doc.
Been a while, I haven't seen you around, little man. Chaos Control.
Right.
That's the way we're doing it with the time traveling. We seem to lie as normal 80 teenagers. I'm 80 teenagers. We play with Milk Crate all the time.
Sent to haul away all those books from Doc's estate sale. Wonder if Biff finished the wax job on my 4x4.
Okay, well, just go in.
Hey, anyone home? There's something wrong with my key.
Please, not now. Tomorrow. Give me another day.
What?
Another day? Dad, what are you talking about?
Marty? No, that's impossible. Marty was run out of town.
Huh?
I've got a bad feeling about this.
The future change?
Run out of town? What are you talking about, Dad? Let me in.
This is a trick. Go away.
Leave us alone. Haven't we suffered enough?
Mom. Get Jennifer on the phone. She'll recognize my voice.
Jennifer? Jennifer who?
Jennifer Parker, my girlfriend.
I don't know who you're talking about.
Oh, great.
How can I convince you?
Tell me something only Marty would know.
Ah. The first time he kissed Mom, it was at the Enchantment Under the Sea dance.
That's right.
Oh, my Lord. What are you waiting for, George? Let him in.
Stupid locks.
Marty!
What?
Oh my God, Dad! What happened to you?
What do you think happened, butthead?
Uh-oh.
Biff!
I thought we told you to stay out of town, shrimp!
Biff, whatever's going on, I'm sure we can handle it. Reasonably. Who are they?
Like you don't know Cliff and Riff. What do you think we should do with him, baby bro? What we should have done years ago, big bro.
Uh-oh.
I'm gonna enjoy this, McFly.
Wait, I'm trying to process here. What the hell did you do to my dad?
Your dad's been in that wheelchair since before you were born, butthead. And you better hope he has a spare, because you're going to need one in like 3 seconds.
Duck.
Ooh. Biff! Wait, does all this have something to do with Kid Tannen?
Pop? What about him?
He was supposed to end up in jail.
Jail? Pop's never spent a day in jail in his life.
Yeah,
the Tannen gang's the fifth most dangerous crime family in California. We got connections all over the place.
No way.
You don't believe me?
Biff, no!
Come on!
Bang! Ha ha! Check it out.
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, JJ Valenti.
It's Don Valenti, godfather of the Sacramento mob. The third most dangerous crime family in California.
Middle butter. This could very well be. Up the crate.
I got a question. What are you guys doing here anyway?
It's that time of the month. Time for Georgie to pay up. We usually take the payment in cash, but this month we can take it out of your hide.
I have a lot of time to thinking. Yeah, why not?
Hey!
And another thing. Why are you guys so pissed at me?
You don't remember? You've really lost it, McFly.
What?
Think back. The thing with the manure truck.
Huh?
Which one?
Yeah. That way. Up on the crate again.
What about my mom? I mean, how did she end up with my dad?
Beats us. Guess she has a thing for losers. She could have had any one of us, but she went for old Gimpy McFly.
Yeah, lost him.
Here's what I still don't understand. How long have you been coming down on my dad like this?
Ever since that school dance, when Georgie laid Biff out in the parking lot. Shut up, it's not funny. Someone messes with the Tannen family never lets him forget about it.
Mm-hmm. So, dot, jump, dot. Oh.
And another thing.
Okay.
Did I get run out of town?
2 years ago. Don't you remember? We made a deal that we'd go easier on your old man if you left. But now you're back, so the kid gloves can come off.
Electric City. I got it. Let's go back. On there. Here we go.
Okay, but... Biff, what happened to you? When I left here, you were kind of afraid, my dad.
Afraid? No Tannen ain't never been afraid of no McFly.
Okay, duck. Success!
Piece of cake.
I never should have let that floozy talk me out of rubbing out your grandfather.
Uh-oh. Huh? What's that? Kid Tannen.
Kid?
No one in Hill Valley messes with the Tannen family.
Hey, Doc.
Marty, get in. This timeline's been compromised.
No kidding.
Somehow, something we did in 1931 allowed Kid Tannen to escape his date with justice. As a consequence, the Tannens have been unchecked in Hill Valley for over 50 years.
Ah, jeez, they robbed the arcade.
We've got to go back to the day Kid Tannen was supposed to be arrested. Figure out what went wrong and fix it. Otherwise, you could be forever stuck in a town owned by the Tannens.
Not an option, Doc. Punch it.
Then back again.
What's okay, some... Doc. Let's run through this again.
Sometime tonight, Kid Tannen is supposed to be betrayed by his mole, a singer named Trixie Trotter.
That hot babe I saw coming out of the speakeasy.
Exactly. When she does, history says Tannen will be arrested by a rookie cop by the name of Danny Parker.
Parker. Hey, do you think he's related to Jennifer Parker, my girlfriend?
Could be.
Heavy.
In any event, somehow we've changed history so that neither of these events happens, condemning your family to generations of abuse at the hands of the Tannen crime family. You need to go back into Tannen speakeasy, find out what's gone wrong, and get Kid Tannen arrested.
No problem, Doc. Let me just put on my hat and I'm good to go.
Here we go.
Is the mustache really necessary?
It's essential. You can't let Kid know that you're the same troublemaker that foiled his attempt to kill me.
Are you sure you can't come in with me?
It's far too dangerous. You may be easy to disguise with your nondescript features, but ever since my daring escape from the police and the mob, my distinctive face has been plastered over every paper from here to Reno.
Nondescript?
I'll find a safe place to hunker down. That flop house ought to fit the bill. You can find me there if you need me.
So, speak easy. Oh, it's her again. What with all this, Salvation Station? What is this?
Huh, looks like Emmett's been busy.
What is he doing here? Uh-oh.
Pardon me, sir. From the way you're dressed and your general aura of seediness, I can infer only one thing. You're heading for Tannen's speakeasy, am I right?
Yeah. Can't you tell me the way?
Down. Straight down. The last stop before the inferno.
Oh.
Unfortunately, I don't have the power to stop you, but I beg you to tarry here a few more seconds and listen to my song. Me, 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 me. You say you've lost your self-respect, but you should care.
Dog.
What in heaven's name?
Oh, sorry, Miss Strickland. Just a little experimental prototype gone momentarily awry.
Mr. Brown, why is there a dog in that vehicle?
Why? Well, to advance the human condition, of course. Hello, Harry.
Harry? Mr. Callahan, what are you doing in that getup?
What?
It's just my new look. I'm trying to prove that you can dress like a gangster without being a gangster, you know?
How exciting! You'll have to give me an exclusive sometime. Right now, I've got some souls to save.
And you'll have to get an eyeful of my newest experiment.
You're not angry about the rocket drill?
Water over the bridge. I've moved on to bigger and better things. Come by the gazebo when you get a chance. I'll be setting up. You won't believe what Einie and I have been up to.
Famous last words. All right. Now, where's that speakeasy?
That's a good question. Like there? That's the movie theater? I've been in there before.
Who sent you?
Ulysses S. Grant.
What did you bring me?
Meat and potatoes.
What's the word?
Words are for wimps.
Okay, so that... If I remember correctly...
Who said you were worthy?
A what? That's new.
Bruce Springsteen?
Take a hike, squirt.
Damn, that's new. Okay. Oh, another one.
Who told you about this place?
Place to call to my travel agent.
What's the big idea?
Stitch in time saves nine.
Settle down, mister. Why don't you wait outside and take a nap?
Napkin, please. I've made a mess.
What? Oh, man.
Ew.
I just need more glue.
Who is the king of Siam?
Oh, God.
Could you repeat that?
Who is the king of Siam?
Hieronymus Bosch?
I just go.
No solicitors.
No solicitors.
Ah, terse and to the point.
Who's your commanding officer?
Commanding officer, Sir Galahad.
Really? Is he as tall as he appears on screen?
On screen,
screens can be deceiving.
Seem all random.
Hoover 28, a chicken in every pot. How's that working out, Herbie?
Harry, you're just in time.
What's the story with the little car and all this equipment?
Einstein and I are conducting a few experiments with this one-quarter scale model to work out a few hitches in my planned demonstration at the Hill Valley Expo in a couple of months.
A radio-controlled car?
No. Well, yes, but there'll be so much more than that. It will amaze the world.
How've you been, Emmett? I know I haven't seen you in a couple of months.
I'm great, and I owe it all to you.
Really?
Yes. That argument I had with my father during our jet drill experiment gave me the incentive to finally quit that dreary court job. I've committed myself full-time to a life of science.
So, thanks for watching Einstein while I've been away.
It's been a pleasure. He's proven to be a surprisingly willing test subject. It's almost as if he's been working with me for years.
More like decades.
Aha! Got it!
Got what?
I'll show you. Ready to go, Einstein? Watch this! When this baby hits 23 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious cow flop.
What? No way!
Einstein!
No!
Get him out of there!
Not to worry. I've got a fail-safe eject mechanism around here someplace. See? Nothing to worry about.
Nothing. I'll go see if I can find something to help. Or someone.
Who could do that thing? Could you help the dog?
Hey, Edna.
Mr. Crockett, what can I do for you?
What have you got against dogs, anyway?
They're smelly, rude, completely unable to take care of themselves, and frankly, they're not very bright. If I had my druthers, dogs would be banned from public places.
Harsh.
It's a harsh world, Mr. Callahan.
What are you doing out here in the middle of the night?
Saving people from alcohol, vice, and disorder. And also keeping a lookout for hot stories. You'd be surprised how much news breaks on this corner.
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh, what is it?
Young scientist strands dog on courthouse roof.
What?
Look over there.
Oh, for goodness sake. Mr. Brown.
Please, Miss Strickland, not now. Can't you see I've got a rather delicate situation on my hands at the moment? My trial run...
Trial run? Public hazard, I call it. And I'm sure my editor will agree. And really, I ask you, a
no, don't you start to lecture me.
Come here, Heine! Come on, boy. Fire escapes this way.
Just a fire escape?
Looks like I'm gonna need more help.
Well then, if you refuse to give me a statement, I just won't tell your side of the story.
Arrgh! Damned exasperating woman. It's okay, Heine. The bad lady's gone. Come on down.
Actually, if this is a sequel to the trilogy, what happened to the other ladies? Theater.
Cool. Frankenstein.
This is a lady from the third part of Back to the Future. What's her name? Clubhouse door. Probably nothing. Yep, walk out. Oh, wait, what?
Hey, Doc, how's the room?
It's a little cleaner than I would have imagined for a Depression era Flophouse. How are your investigations going?
Where'd you park the DeLorean?
I hid it in the DeSoto lot. Nobody's buying cars these days, so it should be safe in there.
Why didn't you tell me I'd run into your younger self tonight?
Because I don't remember being out here tonight. Clearly, your interactions with my younger self 2 months ago have slightly altered my personal timeline. I never have the nerve to perform public experiments like he's doing. No matter. Those experiments will be forgotten once I've seen Frankenstein.
Frankenstein? What?
Yes. Right now, my younger self is fiddling around out there with rocket propulsion systems for his demonstration at the expo.
The thing that'll kick off your scientific career.
Exactly. Now, the rockets are a horrible idea, and I'll soon realize that they'll never work. But eventually, I'll wander into that movie theater and see Frankenstein and clear my mind. I've kept the ticket stub from that movie in my wallet ever since. See?
Why?
Because it's during this movie that I'll have the inspiration for my breakthrough at the expo.
Doesn't have anything to do with reanimating the dead, does it?
Not the way you're thinking, no. But during that famous scene when Colin Clive turned the wheel that raised that shrouded figure into the tower and that bolt of lightning struck, well, let's just say more than one brain was reanimated that night.
Okay,
Emmett's not having much luck getting Einstein off the courthouse.
I'm not surprised. Einstein's a smart dog, but heights give him the willies.
What can we do?
I've got it.
What?
Just get my younger self distracted, and I'll handle the rest.
Okay, what about that Ticket.
Just keep your head low, Doc. I'll be back soon.
I'll keep an eye out for your grandfather.
Okay. Distracted again. Ah, why can't I walk? Ah, kind of wish that there would be a fully 3D control. Right, gonna keep him distracted again.
Edna!
What?
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh, what is it?
There's a new angle on the Emmett Brown story.
What is it?
It's even worse than you thought.
Oh, Lord. Mr. Brown. What is it now, Mr. Brown?
I could ask the same question of you, Miss Strickland.
This scientific enterprise of yours represents a clear and present danger to public safety.
You know what represents a clear and present danger to public safety? Your singing voice.
There's no need to get personal, Mr. Brown.
Believe me, I have no intention of getting personal with you.
I'm relieved to hear it. Flying cars, of all the ridiculous, juvenile...
But just imagine, a world in which traffic jams and car crashes are a thing of the past.
I might be more inclined to listen to you if your maiden voyage hadn't ended in a crash on one roof and a stranded dog on another.
I'm working on getting him down. Einy, how'd you get down? Clever dog.
Well... Fortune favors you tonight, but I warn you to be more careful in the future.
Now, how to get that rocket car back down?
Let's go see Frankenstein. Where's he now? I wish I could just control the camera as well.
Frankenstein.
Yep. Which way? It's just gone, totally gone, like. Not here anymore.
Testing, testing. Sibilance, sibilance.
Hey, quit playing with my equipment.
Sorry.
What? He just popped in and out. Come on now.
Hey boy, how you doing? Good dog.
What's the goal anyway?
Hill Valley Stationers.
Oh, if I... Up stationary side, but I don't think I can get into the shop. Nope, just block out. Or not.
It's closed for the night. Luckily, I don't have a burning need for a greeting card.
Right. Maybe try to go back to the speakeasy.
Who died and made you boss?
Come on.
The old gray mare? Okay, those guys going into the speakeasy were obviously speaking in code.
Yeah. But the code changed every time. Not even
what will you do if I let you inside?
Inside? Side with the enemy.
What will you do tomorrow?
Tomorrow? Oh. Roam the streets.
It's rhyme. The code is rhyme. Okay. So,
who told you to come here?
Yeah. Tourist day? Oh no. Here.
Hieronymus Bosch?
What will you do if I let you inside?
Side up to you,
boss. Side up to your boss?
Where are you going?
Go Rome. Yep, Rome.
Rome.
No! Going
in. Who told you to come here?
Hieronymus Bosch?
What will you do tomorrow?
Row my boat.
Row my boat?
Where you born?
Borneo.
Welcome to L Kid, sir.
Stop.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to once again present the hottest little number this side of the Rockies. And when I say my pleasure, I think y'all know what I'm talking about, am I right? So let's have a big L Kid welcome for the one, the only, Trixie Trotter.
Out of my way, kid. What? I got some sorrows to drown.
I am my own superintendent. My star is on the ascendant. That's why I don't care. I don't care. I don't care what people think of me. I'm happy, go lucky.
Officer? I know you. You're
Parker. Oscar Danny Parker. Hill Valley PD. Have we met? You look familiar.
Nah.
Well, stranger, sit down and have a drink on me.
I hear you've been having troubles.
Troubles? Buddy, nobody knows Mystic, the troubles stop. I've
Why?
Seen.
Want to talk about them?
Do I? Yeah, I do. Listen, it all started when this car...
Every morning, every evening, hey, we got fun. Not much money.
Uh-oh.
Now, about those troubles.
I don't want to wallow in misery. I came here to get happy. Hallelujah!
Oh, boy.
So about those troubles.
Troubles? I don't want to talk about all that depressing stuff. I want a party! Whee!
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
I'm supposed to get this guy to arrest Kid Tannen tonight?
Tonight? Oh, I... Where's she gone? Oh, there she is.
Excuse me, are you Trixie Trotter?
That's what it says on my dressing room door. At least, it would if I had a dressing room.
I really like your voice.
Thanks. You should hear me when I ain't so under the weather.
You're sick?
Oh yeah, sore throat. That's why I'm giving Q-Ball so many
hey,
extended solos tonight.
Gaming Yodos, welcome back.
I kinda wondered about that.
So...
Hey, your songs seem to have a big effect on Officer Parker over there.
I am humbled and gratified that my musical gifts have fallen upon such receptive ears.
How's it going, man? Good gaming. Do you have lunch yet?
Do you know Sister Christian?
I don't do religious tunes.
I
don't care. What are those? Are they lyrics for one of your songs?
I haven't memorized them yet.
Oh, you have. What do you have, man? I might have to think about what I'm gonna have for lunch as well. Well, talking about lunch, well, it's not particularly lunch, but still lunch. What do I have left?
What's a nice gal like you doing with a guy like Tannen?
Kid ain't so bad. He just takes some.
Hey, Toots, any chance you could sing that can-can number? The guys really love the way it shows off your, assets.
Whatever you say, kid.
And quit lazing around. I ain't paying you to yak with the drunks.
You ain't paying me at all, you bum. What were we talking about again?
You were telling me what a great guy Kid is.
Yeah, I guess he is a pretty crummy boyfriend. But until my insurance policy checks out, I guess I'm stuck with him.
Insurance?
Yeah. Look, I may not be the brightest bulb in the marquee, but even I know, you don't break up with a creep like Kid without something to keep him from going all crazy on you.
Insurance policy?
What's this insurance policy all about?
Are you kidding? There's only one person I trust with my secrets, but I ain't seen him in weeks.
You don't mean...
Artie McFly!
Artie McFly.
You know him?
Not as well as I thought.
Before he took a powder, Artie was tutoring me in all sorts of stuff. Etiquette, philosophy, accounting. He's a regular Renaissance man. He even had one of those smart guy professor's pipes, see?
Can I borrow this?
Sure. I've been secretly working on my Get Out of Kid card for weeks now, but Artie's the only one I trust to check my work. You can't be too careful when you're dealing with a maniac like Kid, you know.
Don't tell me I need to fire him again.
Hey, if I arrange a meeting with Artie, could you use that insurance of yours?
Use it? Heck, if what I'm sitting on pans out, I could send that bozo all the way to the big house.
I'll see what I can do.
Awesome.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
She's supposed to turn on Kid Tannen tonight? Okay, Doc, if you say so.
Artie. So, Ice Die? Again?
Hey. Nice suit. Where'd you get it?
Costume shop at the mall. I had it custom made.
Yeah?
Custom shop.
Quality material. Who are you? Where you from?
Name's, Harry Callahan. I'm one of you guys. Don't you recognize me?
No. Come on. What's the dope? Spill it, or I'll...
Go easy, kid. From the cut of the suit, I'm thinking he might be with the Valenti gang.
Is that so?
Yes?
Prove it. You ain't leaving till you show me some bona fides.
Oh. Right. Get ready.
I've got a little something here that might convince you.
Oh, yeah. Uh-oh.
Even blink.
It's not a real gun. It's not a real gun, I swear. It's a gift from Don Valenti. See?
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti. Looks like little Harry Callahan here really is with the Sacramento boys. You got stones, Pee-wee. I like that. Have yourself a drink. On the house. Matches. Put down your gun. You look like a moron.
Okay, can I leave now?
Hey, Artie! He's back!
Okay, catching up! Run! Oh, come on, run! Why don't you running? Yo, can you help me again?
Hey boy, take a whiff of this.
There he goes.
I love that nose.
Frankenstein?
I've been laying low, officer, but I've got to go to the pictures once in a while.
Hello, Arthur.
Officer?
I'll take it from here.
But...
We can talk at the Majestic, away from prying eyes.
Yeah, Einstein, you done good.
Majestic. Now, where's the place? Yeah, I know to go. I know to go. Oh, maybe in the... You mean in that... hotel room? Yep. Flophouse.
Hey, Doc. I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
Okay. What? Never speaking. Yep.
Is Artie still here?
He's in the bathroom.
Hey, Artie, open up. You've got a gangster to bring down.
Is it time for me to meet this Sylvia?
No.
Yep.
It's time for you to meet Trixie.
Trixie says she's got something that might be able to send Kid up the river, but that you're the only one she trusts to check it out.
Me? What is she? Oh, I know what she's done. Clever.
Care to let us in on the secret?
Sorry, guys, but if Trixie's keeping it a secret, then so am I.
That's all well and good, Mr. McFly, but if you and Trixie are going to collaborate on this evidence, we'll need to arrange a rendezvous.
Well, Trixie's chained to Kid's speakeasy.
So we'll have to bring Arthur to Trixie.
Uh-uh. No way am I getting anywhere near that place again. I don't know how you talked me into this.
I don't know
why. Stay back here in the shadows and don't come out until you see Trixie.
You're sure I'll be safe here?
Perfectly safe. We'd never make you take any unnecessary...
Sagan.
Uh-oh.
Where's Kid?
Don't worry.
Right. Get back there. Trash can.
Ew.
Ew. All right, let's...
Welcome back, sir.
Nice.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid?
Let's exploring my options.
Hey, Kid. What is it, Squirt? That's a nice place you got here.
Ain't it? I picked out all the statuary myself when I was traveling through Greece.
I can tell. It's got that tannin touch.
Thanks.
How long have you and Trixie been going out?
You mean knocking boots? Oh, about a year now.
That's a long time.
Tell me about it. I keep meaning to dump her for a newer model, but then she starts singing at me, and I remember why we got together in the first place.
Love?
Free nightclub entertainment.
See ya, Kid.
Yeah, whatever.
You in?
Why not?
Free?
Even's my lucky number. This isn't my game.
Cheat music. Angry song, sad song, secret song, happy song. That. Would that work? Oh, does Bucket refuse to do his duty?
Danny!
You!
So about those troubles.
It all started on June 14th. I was chasing down one of Tannen's boys when this car straight out of Buck Rogers popped up out of nowhere and ran my car off the road.
No!
Then later, I lost track of a witness. The poor schlub hasn't been heard from since.
That wasn't your fault.
And then, to top it off, I somehow managed to lose custody of an 80-year-old arsonist. When not one, but two of those godforsaken space cars showed up and whisked him away.
That's unbelievable.
That's what the chief said. Demoted me on the spot. My family sent me to a psychiatrist because they thought I was seeing things. And worst of all, my gal Betty left me because she thinks I'm a bad provider and a head case.
Betty? As in Jennifer's grandma Betty?
What?
Listen, Danny, it's really important that you get back together with Betty.
Oh, that ship sailed. What the heck with her? I got a little secret that'll set me up with women twice as classy as Betty'll ever be.
Oh, no, that,
See you later, Danny.
I'll be okay. Here.
Change the songs to a secret song. The dead house work. Angry secret song. Spur in my ear.
Got a secret? What is it?
Oh yeah, my secret. Well, you're my pal, so I can tell you, but don't let it get out. I've been working for Tannen for over a month now.
What?
What?
It's true. All I gotta do is look the other way while evidence is getting destroyed or a truck full of gin is coming across the county line, and Tannen makes sure an extra bunch of bills makes their way into my pay envelope. Great deal, huh?
So that is why you are here.
No, not a great deal.
What's the problem? People need to drink, right? As long as no one's getting hurt, why shouldn't Daniel J. Parker make a few bucks on the action?
Right.
What about Trixie Trotter? She'd like to leave Kid, but she knows what would happen if she tried.
Oh, poor Kid. Stuck with a big thug like that. Oh, God. I've made a horrible mistake. I thought if I could get my hands on some money, that Betty'd take me back. But when she finds out what I'd done, she'll never even talk to me again. What have I done?
Okay. What song would... Be...
Hang in there, Danny.
Oh, God.
Okay. Need a song to brighten up the day. This has to be... Angry! Angry! Rage!
Ha
this feeling that has me in its grip? What has me on the edge and curling my lip? Worse than the blues or the front page news, it's rage. I'm overflowing. I've asked my doctor and psychiatrist too. They tell me
okay,
that
let's do this.
Do. There's no consoling and
Danny.
No control
you.
This rage.
Come on, Danny, pull yourself together. It's not so bad.
Not so bad. I'm a corrupt cop who's lost his only chance.
Oh god.
True love.
I should go for happy song first. Okay, okay, fine.
Oh god.
All right, change the song right now.
There's something that I've got to get off my chest. It's rage. I'm overflowing with rage. I'm like a villain.
Have we got fun? How would this
Danny?
You!
Trust me, things will get better. Just keep listening to the music.
Why? None of the words help anymore.
Oh, God.
I don't think there's anything in the speakeasy that can turn this guy around right now. You know, drinking that much is really bad for your health.
What are you, my mother?
More like future grandson-in-law.
What?
Never mind. Hang in there, Danny.
Oh, God.
Gotta be away. Might as well just... Do it. Do it. Sorry. Gonna get back to rage. But anything, not gonna do it right now.
What is this feeling that has me in its grip? What has me on the edge and curling my lip? Worse than the blues or the front page news, it's rage. I'm overflowing. I've asked my doctor and psychiatrist too.
Okay.
They tell me that there's not a thing I can do.
You know what?
You!
I guess now I know why you won't arrest Tannen. You're working for him.
Bingo!
Trust me, things will get better. Just keep listening to the music.
Why? None of the words help anymore.
I don't think there's anything in this speakeasy that can turn this guy around right now.
Yeah.
Hang in there, Danny.
Oh, God.
So, anything inventories? What's this? Seems like it's just a way to get in. Lyrics,
I don't care.
Care.
It's the lyrics to her song.
So, let's do I Don't Care. Perhaps. Oh no. Doesn't work.
They may or may not mean offense, but I don't care. You see, I'm sort of independent. I am my own superintendent. My star is on the ascendant.
Hey, you!
You talking to me?
Yeah, jerk. I saw you making eyes at my Eunice.
Oh, lay off, Ernie. He's kind of cute.
You think you can just waltz in here and make a play for another fella's girl?
Give me a break. She's not my era.
Now you're gonna insult her? I ought to paste you one right feet and the...
Let him go, Ernie. Jeez, you're a mean drunk.
I don't care. I don't care. Trixie?
Yeah?
Guess who's waiting in the alley to talk with you?
Huddy?
The one and only. It wasn't easy to track him down. I had
Cover
to...
Cover for me, Q-Ball. I'm taking a smoke break.
Atta girl.
What? Is that... That simple? Okay. Okay. He up to something.
Hey, you!
Huh?
Yeah, oh, hello, jerk. Distin!
I saw you making eyes at my Eunice!
Wait,
sorry,
what?
Pal. I don't have time for a fight.
Why, you? I'll never get to Carnegie Hall at this rate. All right, fella. I think you're done for the night.
What?
Hey, where do you think you're going?
Me?
Yeah, you. What do you know about this?
Nothing. I... Ah!
What?
Trixie?
Breaks over, Q-Ball.
Whatever you say, babe.
What was that?
That is a... Good question. Huh?
Artie?
You missed a hell of a party, buddy.
Kid, what happened?
Oh, you're gonna love this. So, I'm hanging out in the club when all of a sudden I get an urge to drain the lizard, right? I come out into the alley, and who do I see? None other than that scrawny, subpoena-answering rat, Artie McFly. And get this! The little worm's whispering away all conquistadorial-like with my Trixie!
Oh, no.
Naturally, I pull out Kid Jr. and prepare to put a couple bullets in McFly's head, which causes Artie's nose to start bleeding because he's a big wuss. And then...
What?
Trixie literally gets down on the knees and begs me to let him live!
Huh?
Seriously, down on the knees crying and begging for McFly's life!
So, what did you do?
What could I do? I fired two shots in the air and told Artie to take a hike.
Huh, that was merciful.
Hey, I got plenty of mercy. Besides, now Trixie owes me big time. And Kid Tannen always collects on his debts. Always.
Uh-oh. That complicated things.
Welcome back, sir.
How's going anyway, Destin?
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid?
Must be an evening in your sight now. I try to cover all the time, Sony. Okay, Trixie.
Trixie?
Yeah?
I talked to Kid.
Oh?
He told me about Artie.
Oh.
It was awesome of you to plead for his life.
And it was awesome of Kid to spare it. So you see why I gotta get rid of all the dirt I got on Kid. As long as he's loyal to me, I gotta stay loyal to him.
About Artie McFly.
What about him? Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
Oh, yeah, he's okay.
Are you sure?
Believe me, if he wasn't okay, I'd be the first to know. Okay, so Kid spared Artie's life, but that doesn't make him a saint.
Believe me, no one knows that better than me. But if Kid can let Artie off the hook, I guess I can let him off the hook. Know what I mean?
Actually...
About Artie McFly.
What about him? Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
I think something bad might have happened to him.
What? You mean Kid went back on his promise?
Yeah, that's right.
That's what.
Oh, no! Oh, poor Artie! Poor
I know.
That rattlesnake kid! He can't get away with this!
You gonna turn over the evidence you got against him?
Am I ever? Just watch me! Wait a minute. What evidence do you have that kid bumped Artie off?
It's just a hunch.
Keep your hunches for the racetrack. It ain't nice to get a girl all worked up over unsubstantiated rumors.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
Sorry, lady. I didn't mean to get your boyfriend kicked out of the club.
Oh, water under the bridge. You want to keep his seat warm?
Thanks anyway.
Very good. That doesn't work. Fun. Go. Have the Parker. No. Anything else?
Where do you think McFly ran off to?
I don't know, and I don't care.
See ya, kid.
Yeah, whatever.
I can't fight. Now the McFry again. Come on. Gotta go back and forward. Nice cap. Thanks, man. Yeah, got this one from Thailand Game Show. That little hat. Okay, probably in the Majesty. Could he be back inside there? How could this game even be played on iPad? What the control would be like?
Hey Doc, I could use a little help.
What's weird camera? Yeah, it is. This game is just camera just so messed up. Probably is more attuned to the Resident Evils and all those games. I don't know if the meeting was a flop.
The rendezvous was a bust, Doc. Tanner caught Artie and Trixie in the alley. Trixie begged for his life, but now she's acting weird.
You better talk to her before she does something rash.
Doc, Parker's in worse shape than we thought. We've screwed up his life so bad he's been dumped by Jennifer's future grandmother.
Gah!
I know.
Marty, it's more important than ever that you get Officer Parker back on his destined path. If Jennifer never exists, then I'll never take you to 2015 to save your kids. That old Biffle will never...
Paradox City. Got it.
Right. It's pretty much just two things I need to do here is that...
Okay. I better get back to fixing history.
Be careful, Marty.
Where's Arthur Okay. This one way to fire him. I still have that pipe. So, where's the dog go? No! I stay! Oh great. Just give me a hint. Zane? Who? Wait, what? Who? Who's Zane, by the way?
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Hey!
Take a hike, squirt.
Oh, Zane.
Hey, bartender.
What'll it be?
So about this, portrait gallery of yours.
What about it?
What's it all about? Who are those guys?
The caricatures hanging along the wall of honor commemorate those who are no longer with us on account of having ticked off one Irving Kid Tannen.
They're the guys the kids killed?
Well, of course not. They're just a bunch of guys that Kid didn't particularly like, and that at a later day turned up dead. It's a what do you call it? A circumstantial coincidence. Yeah.
Do you know what happened to Trixie out there? She seems pretty freaked out.
You talk weird, you know that? But no, I don't know nothing about Trixie's emotional state. Kid doesn't pay me nearly enough to pour drinks and babysit his crazy girlfriends.
Got any tips for getting Parker in the right frame of mind?
Well, I ain't no Carl Jung, but I've noticed that when he's boozing it up like he is tonight, Danny Boy's particularly receptive to the lyrical stylings of Miss Trotta.
Huh?
Actually, what is he drawing?
Some guys are inspired by great works of art. Others get their ideas from lounge singers. Go figure.
So, what are you drawing?
What are you drawing?
Another celebrity caricature.
You drew those?
Prohibition ain't gonna last forever, bub. I gotta have a skill I can fall back on when all this goes away.
Think you could do a caricature of me?
Sure. Presto!
That really doesn't look like me.
I didn't have much to work with.
Thanks for the talk.
Next time, order a drink. This ain't no library, you know.
Lee, are those war there?
Louis the Louse, squashed in his prime. The shrew didn't burrow deep enough. Do I really look like that?
Actually, what if I...
I don't think they'd be interested in my caricature. Nah.
Yeah. Do. Make someone sing. Yeah, I did get her to sing before. No, I thought it's the dead ring of a young child. New subject to draw, yeah, I did that. What? So. I would.
You think you could draw a picture of this guy?
Sure. Hey, that looks like that Artie McFly think.
I never noticed that before. Hey, can you give him a hat like Artie wears?
Voila!
Nice job.
Now go tell them chumps at the New Yorker.
Okay, and now if I...
I don't think anyone will be interested in this caricature while it's hanging on the wall of Kid's Club.
Unless if I put one of those eggs on.
Sorry about this, Dad.
Well,
Checkerboard Charlie removed from the board. I guess someone jumped him.
Okay, so that up now. The next thing is to tell her that Adam McFly.
Yeah?
It's not doing well.
About Artie McFly.
What about him? Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
It's not okay.
I think something bad might have happened to him.
You think?
Yeah.
And you think Kid did it, so you think I'd better hand over what I got on him.
Yeah.
Well, I think you'd better come back when you got something a little more solid.
Well,
I don't know how to tell you this, but I think you should check out the Wall of Fame.
Why? What is it?
Yep.
Artie! I don't believe it! We had a deal! Artie was supposed to be safe!
I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. Felony tax evasion.
What?
Before he died, Artie was teaching me about all sorts of stuff. Literature, history, accounting. And I made a big discovery while I was copying all of Kid's books. This establishment ain't entirely on the up and up.
Really?
Hmm.
Oh, I knew about all the gangster stuff. That kind of thing you expect from tough guys like Kid. But when I found out he ain't been paying taxes on his speakeasy profits, well, cheating Uncle Sam is one step over the line. Once I turn this over to the police, they'll throw the book at him.
Aha!
This book! Hey, copper!
Oh, here we go. Oh, come on.
He's not interested. Figures. Half the police force is in Tannen's pocket.
Okay,
so that... minutes to work on him. I've got a hunch he'll come around.
But that's the next step.
Boss?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a good time here.
I think you'll want to see this.
What?
Are you crazy? Bringing a stick of dynamite into my club?
That's just it, boss. It's all over the place. I think our speakeasy arsonist is getting ready to strike again.
A secret part? Right, so...
Danny!
You!
Trust me, things will get better. Just keep listening to the music.
Oh yeah, why? The music doesn't work.
None of the words help anymore.
I don't think there's anything in the speakeasy that can turn this guy around right now. I guess now I know why you won't arrest Tannen. You're working for him.
Bingo!
Yep, got it.
Hang in there, Danny.
Oh God.
Can't go out either. Yeah, I don't think any salt. Oh, wait, my. Can I do anything with it?
Way down in Louisiana, down in New Orleans. Maybe not.
Maybe not.
Hey! I do the singing round here.
Yeah.
I don't care. Trixie?
Yeah?
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
Song doesn't work. Yep, nothing in. So is there anything else apart from not sure if this. I don't think it is, but Have you talked to this guy?
Hey,
anything special?
Back off, kid. I'm trying to entertain some people here.
Damn.
I don't think so.
Yep, neither am I. There's some sheet music, some- Oh! I got it! There's, another music outside. Edda? Yeah! With all this control.
Edda. What? What was that song you were singing earlier?
Do you like it? I wrote it myself. It really gets the toes tapping at the Stay Sober Society meetings. Although I suppose that could be the shakes. Would
Stay
you like
sober.
To hear it again?
Yep.
Sure.
I knew if I waited long enough, somebody would request it. You say you've lost your self-respect, but you should care. It's not too late to redirect and start to care. Don't despise the good and pure. Time to rise up from the sewer. Wash off all that foul manure. Show the world you care. You should care. You should care. What people think of you.
Oh God, stop playing.
A good hat, you could name reclaiming. Your good name is what you ought to do.
Okay, that's enough. That's enough. Okay, that's enough.
Catchy.
That's enough.
You really think so?
Oh,
yeah,
God.
It's got a good hook to it. One
okay.
needs a good hook if one is fishing for souls.
Okay, so I have a copy of your song.
Do you think I could have a copy of your You Should Care lyrics? I've got a club of my own that could really use some inspiring.
Sure. Let me just get a page out of the hymnal. There you are.
Hey, thanks.
Awesomeness.
I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
Kid Tannen arrested.
Oh, glorious day! When did it happen?
Well, it hasn't happened yet, but it's gonna.
Keep me posted.
Okay.
See ya.
Keep fighting the good fight.
Right. Right, try this music. That should work. From I don't care to I should care.
Welcome back, sir.
Looks like Parker's still parked.
Right, let's put that music in. Oh, wait. Actually, could I just ask her to do it?
Hey, Trixie, look over there!
Why?
Swap.
Didn't you see it?
No.
Ah, never mind.
Lilac for her shoot gear, and now swap that to you shoot gear.
She's right. I can turn my life around.
Sure you can.
You know what? I used to be a good cop. And yeah, I've had a few bad breaks. Possibly even a psychotic one that caused me to imagine a disappearing space car. But I'm a good man.
Yeah.
And all I need to do to win Betty back is be the same good man I always was. And let the chips fall where they may.
Oh, yes. Now,
hey, Miss Trotter.
Get
now,
together.
You wanted to speak with me?
But tenant is still here.
What happened to my louse of an ex-boyfriend?
I don't know.
Rats. I told the chief we need a team of bloodhounds like they got over in Placerville. Yeah, but in the meantime... All right, everyone. Party's over. Everyone out of the speakeasy.
What?
Speakeasy? No?
You're mistaken, officer. This is an ice cream parlor.
Nice try, you. Out!
Kids ice cream. Match.
Callahan. Would the Valenti mob be willing to help, defuse this little situation?
Yeah.
Sure, no problem. I'll bring it up in the next, company meeting.
Hey, we ain't begging here. Kid just thought JJ might like a piece of the action. Especially now that he's just caught the speakeasy arsonist.
Wait, you mean... Doc?
Doc? You ain't with the Valenti gang at all, are you? What do you know about the arsonist?
Come on, you. Off to the station house.
Kid's gonna get you, rat. He's gonna get all of you.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's that. Thanks to Miss Trotter's evidence, the entire Hill Valley Police Force is out looking for Kid and his goons.
You don't understand. We've got to find him now. He's captured a friend of mine.
Who?
Never mind.
Oh, yeah, never mind.
We've got the entire town square sealed off.
I can't even say.
A mile of here. We'll find him eventually.
I don't think we have time for eventually.
Right. So. Probably, could that help?
This is no time for word games. Maybe not.
Gonna have to get something. Huh? Barrow? Where's
Parker
it come
must
from?
Have confiscated this hooch from the speakeasy. Ew.
Hey, something new there, Flex?
Irving Kid Tannen. Guess he awesome. Dropped this on his way out.
Why'd you drink
empty.
It?
Figures.
Alright, so that and Ice Die should be able to find where he is.
Hey, Einie, get your nose over here. Alright. I really don't think Tannen and Doc are with Herbert Hoover, Einie.
Secret door.
Okay, I'll check it out. Button.
What? Of course, press it. Press it.
All right, Doc. Here I come.
Callahan, what are you doing here?
Never mind. Come here and help me get rid of this stinking arsonist.
Edna?
I caught her planting dynamite while he was clearing out the soup kitchen. Guess Sagan was innocent after all.
I was researching a story, you ignoramus.
Tell it to St. Peter, sister.
Hey, what's all this?
Uh-oh. Parker!
Tannen, you're under arrest.
Get him, Sacramento boy.
I can't do that, kid.
What? Oh, I get it.
Why don't you let go of Miss Strickland and call it a night?
Hey, look over there!
Oh, come on! What? Come on! That heavy machine.
Give it up, Tannen. The alley's blocked off and so are the roads out of town. It's over.
Over? Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over.
Do I have?
I don't think he wants a smoke right now.
No.
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen.
He's not about to let me in. What should I do?
Do you have a gun?
Not a real one.
Beats me.
Hey, kid.
Lead, phony.
Damn. Anything I could use? Barrel? Oh, wait, hang on.
No one messes with Kid Ten.
Not sure what that'll do.
Light it up?
Not sure what that'll do.
Here am I. Up, trash can. Really? That has trash can and bulletproof? Barrel.
Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
Yeah, with me dancing on your grave.
That doesn't do anything. Yep. Can't get in.
He's not about to let me in.
Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me?
Oh, wait, what's that? Said he got attention.
I could do this all night, Parker.
Come on, distract it. Say what?
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen.
Tannens never make things easy.
Where was that door? Oh, just pretty much keep him distracted.
Not about to let me in.
No one messes with Kid Tannen.
Hey, moron!
Moron, this!
Yo, Tannen!
Make like a tree and die, rat!
Okay.
Come on, kid.
Whoa!
Just pick it up and put it in the pocket.
Hey, kid,
eat lead, phony.
Okay, what could I do with the barrels?
Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me?
Oh, okay, can't get in.
He's not about to let me in.
What could I do with it?
Tannen's hooch is leaking all over the place. I'd better be careful with this stuff. If Doc could turn it into rocket fuel, who knows what'll happen if it gets into that dynamite.
Dynamite!
Bowling for 10.
And you know what? Light it up. Yeah, that's right, isn't it?
Hey, there's an idea. But not while Edna's in there.
Yeah, I had to get her out first.
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen.
Tannens.
Okay, gotta keep him distracted, I guess.
Hey, kid.
Lead, phony.
Come on.
Hey, moron.
Moron, this.
Ooh.
Yo, Tannen.
Make like a tree and die, rat.
Ooh.
Hey.
Uh-oh.
Atta girl.
Moron! Moron, this! No one messes with Kid Ten.
Okay, and now should...
So,
I'm afraid I'm finding it difficult to concentrate with all the bullets flying around my head, Mr. Callahan.
Bryce!
Come on, kid. You know...
Alright. Let's light it up. Must be a very strong stuff.
Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at...
Hey, kid.
That ain't a real gun.
Oh, right. I forgot. I better just get rid of it then.
Oh, crap.
Dynamite.
Hey,
oh, come on.
Away.
Oh, no.
Yes.
No.
There. Good as new.
Uh-oh. Oh, look, Tannen.
The judge's son.
Uh-oh.
All right, Parker. I want a getaway car and a clear road to Nevada, or the brown kid gets it.
Doc.
Marty.
Doc?
Yes, it's me.
I'm talking to you through the radio apparatus my younger self has installed in the rocket car. What's going on up there?
It's not good, Doc. Trixie and Parker did their part, but now Kid's holding you hostage.
Right, Scott.
No kidding.
Try to get Kid in the car. Once he's inside, give me a signal, and I'll do the rest.
How am I?
You!
Uh-oh.
Emmett.
You're the cause of all
what?
Of this, ain't you?
It's just... Stu.
Should've known. You don't look like any Callahan I ever seen.
Yeah, well, what kind of gang...
Oh, doesn't work. Okay. Anything. Damn.
No one makes a fool out of me, you...
Yep, no. First left, good right. Any tools they could use?
Got any last words, rat?
No! No, I don't think anything would be...
Is that where you... It's empty, so what's the point?
Yep. You got it. Mm-hmm. Harness.
Dot. Come on, bring it on, you big ape.
Damn, just can't close the thing.
Come on.
Hey. Here we go.
Doc, hit it.
What the hell? Woohoo! Taken!
Always.
Irving Tannen, I'm placing you under arrest for kidnapping, attempted murder, tax evasion, and smelling like a piece of crap.
Tax evasion?
Haven't you heard? The feds are practically drooling over Trixie's books.
Trixie?
That's what you get for killing Artie, you bastard!
What? I didn't...
Trixie?
Artie?
All right, Grandpa.
My poor car.
I believe I owe you an apology, Mr. Brown. Thanks to your ridiculous contraption, Hill Valley's most notorious criminal is finally headed to prison.
No apologies necessary, Miss Strickland. My rocket car may have accidentally saved the day, but only because it's a completely out-of-control failure. I need a new idea.
If you're willing to listen, I might have a few suggestions.
But first, I think we should take in a movie.
I'm all yours, Mr. Brown.
Uh-oh.
I think you'll like it. It's all about a brilliant scientist with an overabundance of hubris.
Whew,
Come on, Einie. Let's go find Doc. Thanks for letting me fly the DeLorean, Doc. This thing's a blast.
I'm absolutely sure that everything's back to normal.
Totally. Kid's going to jail, Emmett's going to see Frankenstein, and there's no such thing as a Tanning crime family in 1986. And we remembered Einstein this time, too.
Hill Valley crime rate at all-time low.
Well, except for Grandpa necking with Trixie, I think we're ready to go back to 1986.
Yeah, the Trixie part.
Are yourself fading out of existence?
No.
Then as long as your father's still born in 7 years, I say, let your grandfather sow his oats.
Sowing oats? Is that what's going on with you and Edna?
What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Emmett and Edna. They're gonna go see Frankenstein together.
That's odd.
Oh, the ticket.
Gotta get back in.
Oh,
this could be disastrous.
Stop. Uh-oh.
Where'd you go, Doc?
Relax. We've got everything under control.
Doc?
Uh-oh. Is it just me or feel like the second episode actually shot that in the first one? Oh, the next episode,
Martin
come
McFly,
on.
Age 18.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time.
Father George, Mother Lorraine.
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown.
It's
not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was.
A re-education program? What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
Zero demerits until this morning.
We're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
My own girlfriend thinks I'm a square?
The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?
And they're gonna using all the song from the movie throughout. Oh man, how long this each episode is going for?